MP Peter Bone joins us now. Obviously, some of your constituents, as many people have across the country, have been affected by this change. And yet, we know costs have to be cut. What's your take on it?
Well, first of all, you know, the general principle of trying to get as many people into work as possible is great because work helps people and, you know, unemployment's at the lowest level since 1973. So that principle is right. And there has to be an assessment system and they have to make the rules. But what my problem as an MP, and I think across the House of Commons, is that Motability, some of the people that come to see me clearly should not have had their PIP taken away from them.
PIP meaning
personal dependent benefits, if you like, which they're entitled. And it's a good, generally people welcome that system, but it's the failure of the assessment. So people clearly come to see me who should not have lost their benefits.
But you see, Peter, part of the problem is, and Celia, my heart breaks for Celia out there, it's obvious her disability and what's wrong there, but it is also obvious there are a lot of people, and there's a lot of talk, that shouldn't have these cars in the first place. You can't take away 50,000 cars in a year without a lot of them not being deserved.
You're absolutely right. But what my problem is the appeal system.
Yeah.
Now, people rightly go to appeal, and I say, look, go to appeal. You'll have the mandatory reassessment. It'll come back the same. When you go to the actual tribunal, the independent, you'll probably win. Now, my argument with the minister has been let people keep their car until the appeal system. Now, the great thing about it, Penny Morden, the minister, is very onside on this issue. Mm. They're looking at it at the moment. They say very shortly they make an announcement. I hope they're going to say people keep their car until the final appeal. And I think they're looking at whether they can extend it to other people. It's good that they're looking at it. I think they're listening. This isn't a party political issue. People on both sides of the House say this is just not right. You shouldn't take away someone's car, which is vital to them, until they've exhausted their appeal system. And there'll be another benefit, because appeals are taking a long time. Mm. If the government had to give them the car until the appeal, there'd be an incentive for the government to get the appeals done quicker.
It's a shame it has to go to appeal anyway, though, isn't it? Because that's costly in itself. Why can't we have a system whereby people like we just saw there who obviously need it, get it, and the ones who are abusing it don't?
That's the problem.
Wrong?
How do you tell until you have a system? And, you know, to be fair, as you rightly say, a lot of people were abusing the system, and they, of course, don't go to appeal, and that money can reinvest in helping the people that need it. But there are people, every MP every Friday will see people who they see them and say the appeal system has gone wrong. You know, the assessment's gone wrong.
Sure,
Let's go to appeal.
But Peter, what happens to the cars?
They take them back.
And they go back to the dealership?
They go back and then they get them back again after they win their appeal.
Or do they get given to others?
No, the principle is this. Yeah. When you win the appeal, you get your backdated money. Well, that's very nice. But they give you the car back. Well, hang on a minute. You need it for the three or four. You might even have to go to work. And what happens in these cases is that friends or family have to help. That's not right. Let people keep the car until the appeal system.
What
and I think
if
the government's on side.
Their appeal, though? I think
well, that's fine. And that's the point you make.
Where does the car go?
Then it goes back to into the system. Well. And that's fair. But give them, don't take the car away before the appeal system
tell
is
you what,
exhausted.
It would be very hard if I sat on an appeal committee to take a car away from Celia.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Thank you very much indeed. Peter Bone, that's what he wants. He's an MP and he's saying, look, you know, appeal, but don't take the car away until it is finally ruled you deserve it or you don't deserve it. Now, the Department for Work and Pensions, they say this. Since personal independence payments as the PIPs were introduced, just 7% of decisions have been appealed and 3% have been overturned. Most people leaving the Motability scheme are eligible for a one-off payment of £2,000 to meet needs, and they constantly review the process to make sure it is working in the best way, it says.
You're hoping that that review includes your proposal, aren't you?
I'm sure that within the next 6 weeks or so, we'll hear from the government, and I hope the campaign wins. I think the government is listening on this.